When I'm out at our parks, like my Yakka or here at the Selvert Fields, the question always comes up, are there alligators here? The easy answer is yes. If you're looking at a lake or a creek or a man-made mitigation pond, you're looking at potential gator habitat. Should you be scared? No, but be aware. Gators are fascinating animals. They are prehistoric in every way. While classified as reptiles, alligators are more closely related to birds, the direct descendants of dinosaurs. Alligators are important to tourism in this state. One of the oldest continuously operating tourist attractions here in Florida is the St. Augustine Alligator Farm. In the past, it shows people a real thrill. Today, the farm is more than just gators. It is active in wildlife conservation and education programs. Now, if you see an alligator that's 10 feet long or more, then it's probably a male. The largest male in Florida, at least so far, is over 14 feet long, and the big males can weigh close to 1,000 pounds. Baby gators stay close to mom's protection for many months. Beware of the cute babies. Mama may be around. Only a few of the babies make it to adulthood. They become meals for birds, fish, raccoons, and even other gators. Once they become adults, their main predator is man. And if they're lucky, they can live for 50 years or more. Extensive hunting nearly wiped out the alligator population. In 1973, they were listed as endangered. Species population rebounded, and within 15 years, it was out of danger. They like the temperature between 80 and 90 degrees, but they can be active on either side of that. I've seen males in 60 degree weather bellowing to ward off other males. Of course, the water temperature may have been much different from the air. Gators are quick in water and on land. While they are better suited for the water, they can quickly grab an unsuspecting meal on land. Don't believe the old run in a zigzag myth. If you are charged by a gator, run away at your top speed. Of course, you should never be close enough to a gator to provoke an attack. These critters are especially active in the early morning and at dusk, but they can feed at night as well. They have excellent eyesight. Since 1973, there have been 24 fatalities in Florida from alligator attacks. That's a little over one death every 2 years. Given the 1.3 million alligators in this state and the millions of people who live or visit here, you are much more likely to be hit by lightning.